Hey guys, Speed Force Vector here. So before we start the video and hop into everything, I want to start off by saying this. I am working on my Toy Sweetness episode 2 of LEGO Friends. I started half of the recording, but in real life has just gotten crazy. Nothing like bad or anything like that. It's just a matter of time, and time just keeps going, nah, you're not gonna work on this. So be patient on that video. It'll come out when it comes out. So I'll just be doing smaller videos to keep you guys tied down until that happens. Also, because this video is about merchandising, I do want to say this. Because of the pandemic, we're at a weird time. Merchandise is just going to be very, very slow. And I've noticed when looking up Trolls merch, half of it did not come out or even been released due to the situation. So let's just be mindful of that since we are talking about merchandise in this video. So anyways, off to the intro. So with my Toy Sweetness videos, I've touched on Friendship is Magic and how important that is. And one of those things happened to be the whole demographic thing and how Friendship is Magic approached that situation. And I want to remind you, Friendship is Magic didn't start making merch for its older audience and a male target demographic till around late season 2 and into Friendship is Magic's third season. That may not sound like a long time, but that kind of is if you're a fan from day one. But these things do take time to happen. They don't really happen overnight necessarily. So, if we're thinking about Friendship is Magic, this thing really didn't happen overnight or day one when the franchise first even launched. Hasbro's initial intentions were small, young, female kids, and that was it. They weren't thinking older kids and every gender in between, They weren't really thinking about that. So I think that is definitely important to bring up, but I do think that it is important that Friendship is Magic did start the trend of making merchandise for not its target demographic. I think that's very important, and I wish more franchises that are similar to Trolls and Ponies would do this. And this is kind of where this conversation is, but I do want to specify Ponies did kind of spoil us with this, but this did not happen overnight. Ever since Trolls' first trailer was shown off to the world, Trolls has always had an upper hand against My Little Pony: Friendship is Magic. Plus, both are from Hasbro, and I feel like Hasbro had really no control over the story and everything compared to Friendship is Magic. It was all DreamWorks letting its storytellers telling the story they wanted to tell. All Hasbro did was just make toys, and that's it. But it is definitely interesting that this is the factor. Because when you look at Friendship is Magic, all of the characters are female except for Spike, who is like the only boy protagonist. In terms of its earlier years, there was more characters added much later on, but not exactly main staples to the main six. With Trolls, on the other hand, it was like, yeah, we are cutesy and most of our merchandise is for girls. And yes, Branch is blue slash gray. He's clearly for the boy demographic. But when you look at the other stuff, it's like, oh, Branch and Poppy aren't necessarily the standard, Poppy's pink, of course, she's going to be for girls. Branch is for boys. He's gray slash blue, depending on how Trolls wants to market him in marketing, in merchandise. But he's not necessarily, the standard for boys either. That's how DreamWorks and its storytellers approach this. And who are Poppy rescuing? They're not rescuing DJ, the twins, and Smidge. They're also re rescuing Cooper, Guy Diamond, Creek, and Fuzzbert. They're rescuing pretty much a gender-neutral cast. So it really wasn't like, oh, Poppy's on a rescue mission to save her best friends who are female. Branch is the boy character who tags along, and Creek is kind of like that wedge between these two characters. That wasn't the case. And due to that, Poppy, Branch, and her friends, they all got to be for everyone. It wasn't for, oh, you have to like, Poppy's pink, she's a girl, this is for the girls. Guy Diamond, he's for the boys. No. Everybody has the Trolls character that they like in particular, and it's diverse between among different genders, race, etc., etc. Different people like the troll characters for different reasons. And that's kind of why Trolls had the upper hand. They had male characters in the cast. And I'm not saying that, oh, girls are yucky. No. I'm not saying that. And I'm also not afraid of Brie Larson driving cars. But I will say that this is definitely an upper hand. So in that way, in a sense, kind of like Littlest Pet Shop, it doesn't make parents go, isn't Trolls for girls? There's an awful lot of girls characters. Nah, we're not going. Nah, they had Branch, they had Guy Diamond, so they're like, oh yeah, I can take my 5-year-old son to this. It's not a girls only event. So that's kind of like the most important thing about really the storytelling and also the characters not necessarily being specifically for a targeted person. I will say this though, it is obvious that that is the kind of like the gist of how it's marketed, but that's not how the storytellers approached it. May I remind you, two dudes directed this thing, and there's like a couple females on like producers and writing staff. So even the troll staff is very diverse, even Beat Goes On. So I think that is an important thing to look at also. Compared to Ponies, Ponies was on the Hub Network. Most cable providers didn't have this. Also, Ponies was also not always on Netflix. So really, honestly, despite Ponies blowing up in popularity, if this weren't to happen, and let's just say it was in a Polly Pocket situation, no one would know really this thing existed too much. So Ponies, on the other hand, just didn't exactly have the luxury of having the My Little Pony movie and that being the start of the franchise. They didn't really have that compared to Trolls, and Trolls had a lot more eyes on it as well. Trolls' biggest thing that I could say that I can applaud them for, and this is the reason why I talked about Trolls the way I did in the last segment, is because the Trolls toys are very gender neutral, and this is like the most important part of the franchise because it is based on the toys that it's based off of a long time ago. The good thing is, yes, there is obvious merchandise that is aimed towards a female demographic, but there is that nice option of, oh, cool, this toy happens to have Poppy, Delta Dawn, Branch, and Biggie inside of it. Oh, cool, you get every Snack Pack member. Oh, nice, I could just individually buy a Guy Diamond or Tiny Diamond figurine if I wanted to. There's that nice sense of, oh, okay, I could pick up a Branch toy easily. Bada bing, bada boom, done. No real worries about anything. And that's definitely nice. But The issues definitely arise when you go into t-shirts and other things. Back in 2016, there was enough shirts for boys, but the issue was it was mostly t-shirts of Branch just being his iconic, grumpy, and sarcastic self. There was no other characters. Except for one shirt for toddlers that had Branch and the other male Snack Pack members. You see the issue with this? There's no Poppy, there's no DJ, there's no twins. There's no female characters to be seen on these shirts. And that sucks because, as I said in another segment, Trolls characters aren't for a specific gender. Anyone can enjoy a DreamWorks Trolls character, and that very much, back in 2016, this very much created a divide between what boys can enjoy in Trolls and what girls can enjoy in Trolls. It also did not help that there was not a lot of shirts for boys, and that's still an issue, even with World Tour, and I'll talk about that in a few minutes, because girls pretty much got everything for shirts and clothing related. They got everything, and the boys just got so little. I will say this, Trolls World Tour merch, in terms of clothing for boys, is a little bit better. There's actually Poppy in some, there's actually Barb in some. They're doing good. Again, the same problem is there's not that much. It is very much lacking, and there's so much girls' clothing. They get so much compared to the boys that are just getting less and less. So I think it is definitely important that they do make more stuff for the boys. The best thing about Trolls World Tour is we got a whole lot of male characters that are at the forefront. It's not like Trolls the Beat Goes On, where we get like Milton or Sky Toronto, and like it's on a Netflix show that probably not a lot of people are watching, so they won't know that other male troll characters that are not Snack Pack. Exclusive, you know, there were more male troll characters created. It's just that you didn't notice. But here it's like, yeah, we got Trollix, we got Hickory, we got a whole bunch of other characters here. So that's the good thing. I will say this, in terms of other merchandise, I think that there needs to be a nice divide in a sense, but not too much. I think Trolls' whole thing is being cute and colorful. And I think that they could still do that with boy merchandise. They just kind of need to make the colors and just add more boy characters. I think that's all they really need to do. And there's nothing that would be really lost. Also, I think it would be good if like other merchandise could have maybe gender neutral colors. I think that would definitely help out as well, in terms of other departments of merchandise. But they really need to work on these two things. I do want to present this. Trolls hasn't been around for too long, and also, like, stuff just keeps getting pumped out. 2016, the first movie. 2017, Holiday. 2018 through 2019, Trolls the Beat Goes On. 2020, the second movie. 2020, the show based on the second movie. Trolls really hasn't had a stopping point. So really, there's kind of like this sense, there's like a sense of really not really losing Trolls. I think that's a positive and a negative at the same time. But sometimes there kind of needs to be a pausing point with big franchises, and sometimes it does take time for adult merch to kick in. Or sometimes there's just no adult merch. But I know that Trolls does make that. Also, I think it would be kind of cool if we got troll statues. I think that would be pretty dope. We already got Funkos, so that's kind of everyone across the board can enjoy those. So I think that would be nice if they could definitely do more Funkos and maybe do statues. That would be pretty neat. I have seen some troll mugs and actual trolls dinnerware that's actually like breakable. That'd be kind of cool if we saw more of those, but so far they've done little things, but nothing too huge, but it'd be nice to see that. Now let's get into the actual part of the title here. Merchandise that isn't just for a female demographic. So here's the thing. So I thought at first there wasn't a lot of t-shirts for females, but turns out there's actually a lot made. Guess who didn't get shirts? Males. That's a big yikes right there. So we're kind of in just a reverse situation. The kids can actually get merchandise for males, but it's just not that many. Where here, it's just adult males just get nothing, where the females get all of the clothing, which is interesting. I will say one interesting thing is now, as I brought up at the beginning of the video, kind of like the little housekeeping thing of an update, I did bring up the pandemic, and honestly, there are Trolls World Tour shirts for adults coming. I don't know if it's just for females, but they are coming. They just haven't happened and hit actual stores yet, or online. They have been revealed. I can't find them again, but they have been revealed and shown off. They do exist. Gender unknown, but I'm gonna assume female. And the reason why I say that is because when I looked at Walmart, I didn't see any World Tour female shirts at all, but there was old school classic troll shirts for males, and that it very much raises the question in terms of merchandise for trolls, does that mean males cannot have DreamWorks Trolls merch? And to me, that just sucks that we get the old school trolls, which I have no problem with. This shirt looks pretty cool that I'm showing up on screen. But like it sucks that we're limited to just the old school trolls, but not DreamWorks trolls, but adult females can actually get that. That sucks, and again, that puts a divide in what males can enjoy and what females can enjoy, especially for adults, and that definitely sucks. In 2017, I saw a Fuzzbert shirt, and I thought it was a shirt. Turns out it was actual pajamas. I was pretty close to buying it, but never did. It's pretty cute. I like it. Now, the biggest thing I always talk about trolls is trolls has always, since day one, ever since they kind of produced more merchandise as time went on throughout 2016 and 17, is the fact that really trolls is multimedia. Trolls had a first movie, it had a random holiday special that aired on NBC, it had a Netflix show, it has chapter books, it has random picture books that have other stories to be told, and then you go into other things such as Leapster games and other things like that. And then you have things such as Trolls Live and also the Trolls Museum. You have all of these things, and this isn't common for DreamWorks. They've never went this big on a franchise ever before, and that's because Trolls is a franchise that is similar to something like Care Bears or My Little Pony. They're toy franchises that never seem to go away because they were built to be multimedia. Even looking past Friendship is Magic, looking past that, Ponies was still built off that way anyways, and Care Bears has always been that way too. Trolls is not used to having a multimedia franchise that needs to have content. They're not used to that. The pattern they're used to is, oh, okay, we got a movie, merchandise comes out. No merchandise, that's fine. The movie gets a sequel, all right, here's more merchandise. Nothing happens. Oh, here's the last and final film, enjoy the merchandise while it's still around before it goes away. They don't produce more or anything like that. They don't really. Once an IP is done, they just kind of don't care about it and they just make a cute little Twitter post. Shrek is kind of like that only one, but all it is now is just like meme t-shirts at Hot Topic. Like compare this to like Disney, who like could make one singular movie, like Aristocrats, for example, and like in like 2020, even though like Aristocrats has like nothing, they only have the one movie, they're still making merchandise of it still to this day. So it's just kind of weird that DreamWorks hasn't really done anything like this before. And with Trolls, they have to keep it a well-oiled machine. If they don't, Trolls is just going to not exactly fade away from existence, but that popularity relevance is definitely going to dwindle. And that's definitely what happened in 2018, 2019, and the start of 2020. Now, the biggest issue, and I brought up those t-shirts, if you look up most Trolls merchandise that came out in 2016, and including those t-shirts, you see that they say all out of stock. And that's because the manufacturer companies didn't produce more. They just kind of, when they produced like a batch of them, they just kind of stopped. And because of that, that definitely caused some problems with stores wanting more troll stuff. A good example, my local Walmart, it actually used to have a dedicated section where it's had like a troll standee, and it'd be like, oh, this is the place where you can find Trolls merchandise. That was taken away because Trolls was not producing like a lot of stuff, or companies couldn't buy more because the stock was so low. And for a while, Trolls had to literally become a blind bag company for troll merch. That's why like the hair huggers and a bunch of other different blind bags just got produced out of nowhere because they needed something. Not to mention like a lot of like the troll toys that are out, companies didn't even put like the new wave of troll toys. And because of that, some stores got them, some stores didn't. And because of that, when those stores didn't have any more, and you know, whatever manufacturing company that made them, they're like, oh, well, we don't have any more. You're just gonna have to deal with blind bags or whatever trolls merch you still have on your shelves. And because of that, that definitely put Trolls into like a weird position of, oh, well, how do we market Trolls now? Beat Goes On was the weirdest era of Trolls because they did not know how to handle the 2D and 3D. And I sound like a Sonic fan right about now, talking about classic and modern Sonic right now. But they did not know how to handle the drastic change in art style. Now, in Japan, they actually got Beat Goes On merch. They got like clothing items and other things. They got plushies. They got other things. While in the US, they would have, like, for example, there's one backpack, I can't find it, but there was a backpack that had Movie Poppy, but in a pattern in the background, it was Beat Goes On Poppy and a bunch of other Beat Goes On characters using those designs. Then on top of that, we had like a tote bag with the Beat Goes On designs, and we had puzzles with the Beat Goes On designs. And that was it in terms of the US. We didn't get anything really that said, hey, this is Trolls the Beat Goes On, still part of Trolls. They did not know how to market it, and that was the biggest downfall they had because they weren't producing Beat Goes On merch or even more Trolls 2016 movie merch. And that definitely caused some problems once the beginning of 2020 hit. So, stores had to hype up Trolls, but they did not have any World Tour merchandise. And because of that, they had to literally find whatever Trolls 2016 merch that was left and put them on shelves. And each time that happened, they had to keep putting more because Trolls hype was kicking in. And they just had to just randomly put whatever they could. And that was a biggest problem for my dollar stores. Because they would put up as much troll stuff as they could, but most of them would be gone because it's trolls, people like trolls, so they had to like hurry up and get more. And then World Tour, they're all perfectly fine. And same goes with the big retail stores like Walmart and Target, they were fine once World Tour came out. And really, it really boiled down to whatever manufacturing companies that were doing Trolls merchandise at the time, they were not producing more stock of it. And I don't really know what else happened, but for some odd reason, stores did not order new Trolls merchandise. And when they wanted Trolls merchandise, there was just less and less. So really, I feel like I know we have the pandemic going on, but let's just say when things get a bit normal, hopefully they make bigger stock, bigger bulk of World Tour merch, because if they don't, they're gonna find themselves in the same problems that happened in like the 2 years of 2018 and 19. And as of right now, there's no Trolls 3 announcement or a Trolls random 30-minute short movie that'll air on television that kind of helps Trolls to have new merchandise, because Trolls Holiday had a couple of merchandise because of the movie. So, like, really honestly, since there's no Trolls 3 announcement, Trolls is really going to have to step up their game with how much they produce and how much comes out. And if they don't, they're going to find themselves in another situation that did happen where they couldn't really market 2016 merch anymore because it was old. So they had to definitely jazz it up a bit in presentation, but they didn't know how. We had like this weird era where only Poppy got new like images, and like the rest of the characters were from 2016. There's nothing new added. Poppy was the only one that was getting new poses and everything. And the background was like either it was like gl a glitter background or it was like a weird disco background. And they didn't know what to do. And they kind of had this period of just not knowing how they could present Trolls going further into before World Tour can come out. They needed something to come out. And they just had like this weird panic time of just not knowing what to do. So I hope that that isn't a problem going forward, since we don't have a Trolls 3 announcement or a new TV special. We do have Trollstopia, so hopefully we do see the US and other regions kind of coming together and be like, okay, we'll make Trollstopia merch. People already know what the trolls look like. I mean, the 2D designs aren't even drastically different, except for art style and direction, and that's really it. But like, to quote Hickory, trolls is trolls. People are going to go, oh, okay, yeah, that's Poppy, that's Branch, I get the deal. So I feel like that's not going to be a problem. People will still pick it up because it's trolls. So I think that they kind of need to do that with Trollstopia and find a design that works after they're kind of done with the world tour phase. I think that was a problem going forward, so I hope that these problems do get solved going further into the franchise. Anyways, I'm Speed Force Spectre, and I'm signing out.